What's up, guys? Back with another Twinmotion tutorial. I'm going to show you today on how to make a rendering using Lumen. Let's get right into the video. All right, so right now we have our scene, and usually you would go here to the plus sign to add an image. Well, I already created an image, so we're gonna skip that step. But just for those who do not understand how to create your image or your scene, you go to the add image icon right here. So let's go to my scene, and I called it render 4. And if you want to rename your scene, you'll click on these three dots here, and then they would give you options to rename it, delete it, or copy the ambiance, or duplicate it. Or you could do a media preview. All right, so now we're gonna play around with some of these settings, and we're gonna use Lumen today. So let's get started. All right, so right now the time of day is 11:33. As you can see, it looks kind of dark. And that's gonna change as we get further along in the video, changing some of these settings. And hopefully we'll come out with a good image. All right, so I'm gonna change this. Okay, our sun intensity is at a weird number. Let's move that up to 25,000. Okay. And, all right. I'm not gonna mess with any of these. Ambient. Okay, so that's starting to look a little better. We changed our white balance up. And that helped. So I believe when you change this exposure, I believe you'll see a big difference. Right now it's at negative 0.88. Let's change it to 1.0. All right, so looking good already. Guys, if you're liking this video, please smash that like button. And do not forget to subscribe as well. All right. So we're gonna change this. And that is to bring in some sunlight into our scene. And you can start seeing some of the shadows casting and some of the sunlight that's bleeding into the space as well. All right, we're not gonna enable our HDRI. Not gonna need it. Okay, so I want to be closer up. Right now my focal length is at 22. I'm going to change that to 30. Vignetting is at 30%. I'm going to crank that up to 60%. Sharpness to the edges. Surfaces, I did 0.5. And here's a real important tool. You can align your camera, and that's just gonna make sure that the camera is at a perpendicular angle to the surface of the object. So if I were to click on that, it's just gonna make sure that we are parallel. Sorry, not parallel, perpendicular. All right, so we wanna make sure that we check mark the parallelism on, and that is to ensure that the vertical is parallel, okay? All right. So before we render, I want to, well, let's go ahead and turn on our Lumen, actually. So here you have real time. Right now we're in real time mode. And then you have path tracer. So under global illumination, we're gonna switch from standard to lumen. So as you can see, our scene has changed dramatically. And here in Lumen, we're able to play with some of the scene detail, view distance, lighting update speed. And here you got the mesh, visualized mesh conflict. So that just kind of shows some surfaces and some assets that are in different colors like magenta or areas in yellow. So magenta means that the areas are too complex. And the areas or assets that show in yellow, that means it's too big or too far away. So when I click on that, that's gonna kind of show the scene kind of what Lumen will pick up and will not pick up. Okay. Okay, so here we have our Lumen reflection settings, and for optimize, it pretty much calculates the data to calculate reflections, right? But if we click on full, that's going to use the real-time data to calculate the reflections. And in this case, I want the real-time data, so I'm going to click on full. And we can boost up our quality of our reflections at a higher value to give sharper results. Right now we're at 2. I believe 4 may be the max. No, it's not max. So the maximum you can go up is 10. But I'm gonna crank it all the way up to 10. We'll do 5. And then we can increase our bounce count. So let's do about 4. Then you can play around with the shadows. So when I'm playing around with the shadows, you can see it gets a little, shadows get a little blurry. I do not want that effect for this scene. So I'm gonna keep that about 500. Guys, please do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe. And also I'm gonna leave the shadow bias there. Okay, so we're not done yet, guys. We're gonna move into FX. And FX can be crucial because this is where you're gonna play with your contrast and your saturation. So for my contrast right now, I have that at 25%. Right now, I think I wanna move up my contrast to 40%. And then my saturation, I believe I moved that up to 55%. And as you can see, that really enhanced my image at another level. You're starting to see the texture in the countertop. You're starting to see kind of the reflection off the stools. So, and you're starting to see kind of a little bit of all the reflections off the pendant lights as well, and some of the reflections off your bowls up here in your assets. So it's starting to look pretty good. So we're gonna add a few more touches and then we'll see what the results come out to be. So here we're gonna go to color gradient. Twinmotion offers different type of gradients. I'm gonna go with day midday is what I'm looking for. Okay, and brighten that up pretty good. We're not gonna put a filter on this one. I wanna boost up the quality of my image, so you go to image, format, and right now it's at 2K, we can click 4K. We definitely wanna have tile rendering selected as well. And tile rendering is just going to export our images at a higher resolution. Okay. And I'm just kind of looking through these other settings to make sure that I got everything. But guys, that's it. And I hope you like this video, and we'll be back with another one.